Good morning, and welcome to Holy Family Church as we celebrate the fourth Sunday of Advent. The Lord dwells among us. David worries that the Ark of God dwells in a tent. Mary doesn't hesitate to allow the Ark of God to dwell within her. God is not bound by human constraints, and yet he asks us to participate with him and cooperate with his grace that the Ark of the Covenant and the Ark of Salvation history may be made available to all. Today's Mass is being offered for the souls of the deceased members of the Zubak family requested by Marion and Greg Zubak, the soul of Ron Trudell requested by Toby, Angelo, and family, and special intentions for Rick Johnson, requested by Phyllis Melko. Please stand and welcome our celebrant, Father Jaron.
God of all places, present unseen, voice in our silence, song in our midst. We are your people, knowing unsure. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come.
The fourth candle of Advent is the candle of love. We light this candle today to remind us of how God's perfect love is found in Jesus. He is God's love in human form. The angel Gabriel came to Mary and told her that a special child would be born to her, a child who would save and deliver his people.
Light the Advent candle for, think of joy forevermore. Christ child in a stable born, gift of love that Christmas morn. Candle, candle burning bright, shining in the cold winter night. Candle, candle, burning bright, fill our hearts with Christmas light.
Let us pray. Loving God, we thank you for your gift of love shown to us perfectly in Jesus Christ our Lord. Help us prepare our hearts to receive him. Bless our worship. Help us to hear and do your word. We ask this in the name of the one born in Bethlehem. Amen.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. Good morning. I feel like there is two TVs there now. We can watch on the TVs as well. Today, I've been thinking about those people who doesn't have a place to sleep. And I just heard the other day, some of our CWL members were telling me, there is around 200 people doesn't have a place to sleep here just in Thunder Bay. Homeless people. So we are getting ready to celebrate Christmas. And when I look around here, we have a very decent place to stay. We can help ourselves to whatever we want. So when we prepare for this great feast of Christmas, Let us remember all those people who are less fortunate, who doesn't have a place to sleep, who doesn't have enough means to support themselves to even to eat. So let us remember them. Also, let us take a moment, pause ourselves to celebrate this holy sacrifice. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. Now when David the king was settled in his house, and the Lord had given him rest from all his enemies around him, the king then said to the prophet Nathan, "See now, I am living in a house of cedar, but the ark of God stays in a tent." Nathan said to the king, "Go, do all that you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that same night, the word of the Lord came to Nathan. "Go and tell my servant David, 'Thus says the Lord, are you the one to build me a house to live in? I took you from the pasture, from following the sheep, to be prince over my people Israel. And I have been with you wherever you went, and have cut off all your enemies from before you. And I will make for you a great name, like the name of the great ones of the earth. And I will appoint a place for my people Israel, and will plant them, so that they may live in their own place and be disturbed no more. And evildoers shall afflict them no more, as formerly from the time I appointed judges over my people Israel. And I will give you rest from all your enemies. Moreover, the Lord declares to you, David, that the Lord will make you a house. When your days are fulfilled and you lie down with your ancestors, I will raise up your offspring after you, who shall come forth from your body, and I will establish his kingdom. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall be made forever before me. Your throne, David, shall be established forever." The word of the Lord. The response to the psalm, "Forever I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord. Forever I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord. I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord, forever. With my mouth I will proclaim your faithfulness to all generations. I declare that your steadfast love is established forever. Your faithfulness is as firm as the heavens. Forever I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord. You said, 'I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to my servant David, I will establish your descendants forever and build your throne for all generations.' Forever I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord. He shall cry to me, 'You are my Father, my God, and the rock of my salvation.' Forever I will keep my steadfast love for him, and my covenant with him will stand firm. Forever I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to the one who was able to strengthen you, according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery that was kept secret for long ages but is now disclosed, and through the prophetic writings is made known to all the Gentiles, according to the command of the eternal God, to bring about the obedience of faith, to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth in her old age has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. As you probably know, that when I read the gospel, I always try to find that very sentence. There are many verses in each gospel passage, but there is always one particular verse that I always look for. What is this particular verse speaking to me? And today, the Holy Spirit will come upon you. The Holy Spirit will come upon you. Being a priest, I'm very privileged to pray over people. In my ordination, the bishop gave me that authority. He gave me that anointing. And now I'm so privileged to pray over people. And there are you know, birthdays. There are happy moments. There are moments of sadness, trouble, anxieties. You know, all these different occasions that I pray over people. And whenever I pray, I always include few things. And number one, I always pray in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I always bring Trinity into my prayer. And the other thing, I always make sure I invoke the Holy Spirit upon whom I'm praying. And I also pray to the angels. So these three things, no matter which type of prayer I'm doing, I always bring these three to my blessing prayers. And whenever I bring the Holy Spirit into the prayer, into that person, I always have seen a light in whom I'm praying for. Today, Mother Mary, yes, it's been said, the most wonderful, best news ever in the history. The Son of God will come upon through you. You will bear a son and you will name him Jesus. The best news ever in the history. And yes, it's the best news, but we all know it wasn't the best for a teenage girl, for Mother Mary. And she didn't know at the time what actually going to happen. When we look back now, yes, it's a wonderful, wonderful news. Back then, probably it was a terrible news for her. You know, when a young girl who is getting to be married and with all these dreams, and now there is something comes to you and you have no idea, and nothing like that ever happened in the history. So she was very perplexed. But then the angel said, you know, after the small dialogue there, the angel said, the Holy Spirit will come upon you and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. And then Mother Mary said, Fiat, let your will be done in my life. So we have Nathan here who confirmed this year. Whenever the bishop come here for Holy Confirmation, he always talk about the importance of Holy Spirit. How the Holy Spirit help us to make the right decisions, discernment, understanding, all these different gifts that the Holy Spirit give us. 8 years ago, when I was ready to come to Thunder Bay, I was the saddest person because I didn't want to leave my hometown, my parents. But now when I look back, I'm really happy. I'm really, really happy that I came. Did I know back then? No. Was it easy? No. Did I pray? Yes. So there are things in our life, that just one example in my life, and you will have so many examples in your own lives that we have no idea why this is happening, how I'm going to take this in my life and how I'm going to move forward with this. But please make sure, ask the Holy Spirit to give you the strength, to give you the hope, and that will give you. And that is what happened in Mother Mary's life. And the other thing I wanted to mention in today's reflection, I always try to compare the Annunciation related to John the Baptist. The angel came to Zechariah when he was in the temple. And exactly the same thing the angel told Zechariah. And then Zechariah asked that question, how this is going to happen? We are old. How this is going to happen? Angel didn't take any time to give any explanations. The angel said, since you didn't believe me, you're going to be mute until all this happened. And when it comes to Mother Mary, she asked all this question, how this is possible? And here, the angel gives more assistance. The angel tried to help her. You know, the angel tried to her, you know, the Holy Spirit will come upon you. This is the plan of God. And the angel take a little more time. And originally I thought, a few years ago, I had this thought. And originally I thought the angel trying to be very partial here. And then over my prayers, I found it's not because the angel being partial, showing partiality here, but because Elizabeth and Zechariah, they both prayed their whole life to have children. They almost, the prayer became a routine for them. You know, they just pray and didn't believe that that's going to happen. That's the problem. And sometimes, and when you look at Mother Mary, being a 16 or 17 year old woman, I don't think she ever prayed to have a baby before her wedding. So that's the difference between those two scenarios. The good message from there, you know, sometimes we pray and we forget this is going to happen. If you have been praying for something for so long, this Christmas season, it is coming on your way. That gift that you've been praying for so long, it is coming. Just trust. Never mistrust. Never be late to believe in what the angel trying to tell you. Because we all know the angels come never late. They always in time. Yes, we have a different timing. We have a different way of want to get things done in our life. But that's not how God want to do things in our life. So God has a time, and that's why the having Holy Spirit in our brain, in our heart, is very, very important. May God bless you. Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us bring our needs to God, who desires to grant us what we need.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis, may the Lord bless him in his zeal and joy for the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our elected officials, may the Holy Spirit conform their hearts to charity and justice as they make their governing decisions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer the harshness of winter, may the Lord, in his infinite mercy, ensure they have adequate shelter and food for their tables. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here today, may the grace of discernment help us fulfill God's plan for each of us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they soon come face to face with Jesus, their Savior. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the recently departed soul of George Allen, and strength and prayers for his family at this difficult time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of the deceased members of the Zubak family, the soul of Ron Trudell, and special intentions for Rick Johnson, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Our loving Father, hear and answer these prayers we offer before you through Christ our Lord.
There was a woman, small as a star, full of the patient dreams of her nation, welcoming in an angel of God, welcoming in God's bold invitation. Let it be done, she sang unto me. I am for you, I am for you, I am for you, let it be. There is a world that waits. in the womb. There is a hope unborn God is bearing. Though the powers of death prowl the night, there is a day our God is preparing. Sing round the fire to awaken the dawn. I am for you, I am for you, I am for you, we are one.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with a love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so, with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down a spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis I, our Pope, and Frederick Colley, our Bishop, and all the clergy, and these people and their families. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Before we share the peace of Christ, I'd like to give a special blessing for all our children who are here, and also all our children who are watching online, and also for all those children, about 25, 26 children, who are preparing the Christmas story for us for Christmas masses. It's so cute. I already received a few videos that they sent me. It's so beautiful, so beautiful. God bless them. So let us give all our children, there are so many children who are here today, let us give them a blessing, and all those children who are watching online. Our loving Father, we ask you to bless all these young, wonderful young children in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Now let us share the peace of Christ. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. The body of Christ, keep me safe for eternal life. The blood of Christ, keep me safe for eternal life. Now it's time for spiritual communion for all those people who are watching from online. So let us repeat after the prayer that Denny is going to say for the spiritual communion today.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Take and eat this bread. Take and drink this cup. This is my body and my blood. When you eat this bread, when you drink this cup, you live in me. This is the bread, come down from heaven. This is the cup of our salvation. Take and eat this bread, take and drink this cup. This is my body and my blood. Salvation. Take and eat this bread, take and drink this cup. This is my body and my blood. When you eat this bread, when you drink this cup, my body and my blood. When you eat this bread, when you drink this cup, you live in me and I in you.
Just a reminder for all our Christmas masses. Christmas Eve, we have 5 p.m., 8 p.m., and 10. So there will be three masses. And on Christmas Day, we have 10 in the morning. And all the masses will be live streamed. And I believe Chris will be here for 5 p.m. And everything else, I hope Vijay will take over. Vijay has no choice, as I said before. So thank you to Denise. Thank you so much for your continued support. And as you can see, there are lots of lights and There is a few more things. Chris and his team, the Maverick, I think. The whole team is coming here now. Thank you, Joey. That's his name is Joey, right? One of his employees. They were here last few days, setting up a few things. Thank you so much, Chris, and thank you, Joe, for helping him, and our wonderful choir. You always brighten up our services here, and as I never asked anybody to come. Especially since COVID started, I never asked anybody to, can you come? But I always found there's lots and many more volunteers that I needed. So I really appreciate your generosity, and I know there are so many people are willing to help me. So that's a wonderful feeling as a pastor. So let us keep up all the works we are doing. So we have one more week to go. Hope we made our plans in the beginning of Advent. So hope you are sticking with your plans. If you forgot your plans, maybe this is the last week. Rewind and refresh those plans, and this whole week, make it even bigger plans for the coming of Lord Jesus Christ. So when we come to the manger this Friday, we will be very proud ourselves. You know, maybe give up coffee. Did he hear that? No? Easy? Easy to do that. A coffee? No, Dennis is never going to do that. So I'm just giving a suggestion, and I know that's a big suggestion, giving up coffee. But something big for the rest of the week, so that when we come here, we can tell baby Jesus, baby Jesus, for your coming, I did something really, really meaningful. So let us all prepare for the coming week. And again, as I mentioned earlier, if you have anybody in your homes, in your neighborhood that need a visit at their door for communion, I can do that. Or you can come by here to the main door or the side door here. You don't have to even come inside the church. I can give you communion at the door here in our church. So think about it. And I know there are a few people already taking communion. When they are here, they asking for small pictures, and they taking communion to their loved ones. So there are many ways we can reach out, like Mother Mary did visiting Elizabeth. So this is a time where we really should make everyone's heart and life more meaningful and more delightful. So let's do anything we can do make that happen. Please stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace and glorifying the Lord by your life.
The King shall come when morning dawns and light triumphant breaks. When beauty gilds the eastern hills and life to joy awakes. The King shall come when morning dawns and light and beauty brings. Hail Christ the Lord, your people pray, come quickly, King of kings.